In this video, we demonstrate how to export a Dolby Vision encoded file using DaVinci Resolve Studio. Dolby Vision encoding is available in DaVinci Resolve Studio version 18 and later. It's supported on Mac OS, as well as on Windows running on Dolby Vision enabled laptops. See the link below the video for more info on such devices. If you are using other hardware running Windows, you will need an active Dolby Vision trim license to enable the encoding feature. Please note that Dolby Vision encodes from DaVinci Resolve are predominantly used for review and approval purposes, peer-to-peer sharing, and for distribution to social media services. In this tutorial, we will export a Dolby Vision encoded file directly from a Resolve timeline. We have already performed HDR color grading, performed the Dolby Vision analysis, and done additional trims. To export, navigate to the Deliver page and select H.265 from the available presets at the top of the Render Settings window. Choose a file name and browse to the location where you want to save the encoded file. Leave the format as QuickTime or set it to MP4. Ensure that the codec is always set to H.265 and leave the Use Hardware Acceleration if Available option enabled, as this setting speeds up the rendering process. Under the Quality setting, we recommend disabling the automatic setting and restricting the bitrate to 20,000 kilobits per second. We also recommend that the encoding profile is set to main 10. There are many factors that affect the data rate selection for video encoding. For standard frame rates, you should set the minimum quality to approximately 15,000 to 20,000 kilobits per second for UHD and 10,000 to 15,000 kilobits per second for HD encoding. Now, navigate to the Advanced Settings. Leave the data levels set to auto and the color space tag and gamma tag set to same as project. Scroll down to Dolby Vision Profiles to make a selection on your specific encoding needs. Dolby Vision Profiles describe the video codec as well as the cross-compatibility with SDR, HDR10 or HLG. For more information on Dolby Vision Profiles, see the article linked. For this video, we will select Profile 5, as this selection retains the Dolby Vision analysis and trim metadata and is supported on all Dolby Vision playback devices. Once all the settings are made, add the job to the render queue and start the encoding process. The encoded file can now be easily shared and played back on a TV, smartphone, tablet, or any other device that supports Dolby Vision playback. You can also copy this encoded file to a USB flash drive and connect it to a Dolby Vision enabled TV for review. If you want to encode a finished Dolby Vision mezzanine file that has been imported into Resolve, make sure that the Dolby Vision version and mastering display selection in the Resolve project match the Dolby Vision metadata. In the encoding settings on the Deliver page, remember to select Profile 5 to preserve the original metadata. You can also encode directly to Dolby Vision from existing hybrid log gamma and HDR10 sources. When encoding from HLG, set the output color space to Rec 2100 HLG. The encoder will take care of the EOTF transformation required for the selected profile. If your source is HDR10, set the output color space to P3D65ST2084 or Rec 2100ST2084 depending on the encoding primaries of the file. The encoder manages the EOTF and color transformations that may be required for the selected profile. Dolby Vision must be enabled for all scenarios, and the mastering display should be set to best match your display in use. On the Deliver page, select Profile 8.1 if you'd like to encode such content to Dolby Vision, as this profile will generate frame-by-frame metadata during the encoding process. Furthermore, Profile 8.1 is cross-compatible with HDR10 devices. Profile 8.4 is supported by all social media platforms that support Dolby Vision. This profile will generate frame-by-frame metadata during encoding and is cross-compatible with hybrid log gamma devices. As Profiles 8.1 and 8.4 are cross-compatible with generic HDR formats, they can also be uploaded to platforms that do not support Dolby Vision yet. You can also select Profile 5. If no Dolby Vision metadata is present, this profile also generates frame-by-frame metadata during encoding. To set up your render, simply follow the instructions described earlier in the video.